Hello, ladies and gentlemen. KJ here, and I would like to welcome you back to a brand new season of the NWL. We had an amazing first season last year, and we are ready to get started here again, kicking it off right after WrestleMania with our brand new champions, our brand new storylines, our brand new wrestlers that we have on the roster this year, one of which is going to actually be debuting here tonight. It is none other than Corey Mills, the surfer dude that we have picked up over the offseason. He is actually going to be in action in our first match of the night, facing off against none other than the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels. But first off here tonight, we have none other than the new NWL Champion, Sting. He has an announcement to the people in attendance. Let's go ahead and head to the ring right now, where Sting is going to make his announcement. So here we go, ladies and gentlemen, with our very first match of the very new season in our very new arena. I announced it on Twitter not too long ago that we have a new arena, and here it is, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you enjoy it. We are ecstatic to be here, not renting out any WWE space anymore. No, we have our own place. We are our own brand, and that is why we have this new arena here for us. And in this new arena, the very first match is with none other than a new superstar on the roster, Corey Mills, as you can see there in the blue tights. He is a surfer dude from California. He has decided to get into the wrestling business, decided to try and make a name for himself here in the NWL, and he is doing that against none other than the Hall of Famer, the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels. Michaels has been having a little bit of a rough time recently in the NWL. He has been unable to really gain much traction, and in fact, at WrestleMania, he suffered a loss at the hands of Cowboy Keith, the second one that he lost to Cowboy Keith. So now he is looking to try and get back on track here as we begin Season 2, and against a new rookie here in the NWL. This could be a great opportunity for Michaels to get back on track, try and teach the new kid on the block a little bit of the ropes. Literally and figuratively, you may take that. However, it's also a good opportunity for the newbie, Mills, to try and make a name for himself. I mean, if he can beat someone like Shawn Michaels, the Heartbreak Kid, can you imagine what that would do for his career? Can you imagine what kind of heights he could achieve here if he can somehow beat this future Hall of Famer here? I mean, there is no doubt that this is a big match for both guys trying to make a name for themselves here on the first episode in the second season. Can't stress that enough as Michaels gets thrown into the guardrails there. That's something that we did not have last season. We had it a little bit more padded, a little bit more cushioned by using the WWE Superstars Arena. However, now we brought our own arena, man. We aren't going with no padding, no. We're all about, you know, we want you to truly feel it when you get slammed up against those guardrails. And that is what it is right now. Steel against the flesh. As Shawn Michaels' flesh just went slamming into the thinly padded floor outside there. Corey Mills taking advantage of the situation by going right after him. He now gets thrown back into the ring by Shawn Michaels as the ref continues to count. He is now up to, well, got up to five as Michaels was getting into the ring. Action already spilling outside the ring on the first match here. It's going to be a wild, wild season, ladies and gentlemen, if the action is already on the outside. As Mills starts raining down some punches, tries going in at Michaels, but he is able to reverse it, and now gets him in a submission hold. Took him down with the leg and then got the leg into a submission. Mills is able to get out of it though. Gets Michael's arm now, who's able to reverse it. And now, gutbuster there by Shawn Michaels. Mills with a rake to the eye, a nice kick right to the gut that levels Shawn Michaels down to the ground. Again, we call him a newbie and a rookie, but this Mills guy, I mean, I'm looking at him right now, and he's got the physique, he's got the body for this. And right now, he seems to have somewhat of the talent. I mean, he seems to be very, very comfortable in the ring. Does not seem to be really too scared in the ring right now. Is he just spine-busted Shawn Michaels down on the mat? I mean, last person I've seen do that to Shawn Michaels was none other than Triple H, man. Oh, and Mills, there's a little bit of that rookie mistakes, comes running in at Shawn Michaels in the corner, but Michaels able to reverse it and just slam Mills right back down the mat. Goes for the pin, but too close to the ropes, and Mills gets the rope break. Some good ring presence there by Mills, knowing that he's close enough to the ropes, and just gets his arm right on the rope and forces the break. But he's looked very comfortable so far in the ring. Shawn Michaels now. Shawn Michaels going for a sharpshooter. Sharpshooter by Shawn Michaels on Mills. But once again, Mills close enough to the ropes that he is able to crawl just a couple meters, and then a sweet chin music. Sweet chin music by Shawn Michaels. But Mills, once again, I've been saying this a lot right now, but it is true. Close enough to the ropes that after the sweet chin music, he rolled right out of the ring, did not allow Shawn Michaels to get a pin. That could have been devastating if he would have gotten a pin. Mills might not have been able to kick out of that, as very few people are able to kick out of the sweet chin music that Shawn Michaels plays on an opponent's chin. And now Mills going after Michaels on the outside, gets back in, and looks like he might be willing to take a count out victory here, showboating to the crowd. But Michaels gets back in. He's starting to hold his chest a little bit, looks like right now, but he comes back in with a vengeance, chops galore to Mills, brings him up to the top rope. Now Shawn Michaels going up there with him. This is a very dangerous situation for both men. Michaels going for a suplex! A suplex from the top rope, Shawn Michaels! He is hyped up, he is showing the DX, goes flying off the ropes but crashes and burns. Mills able to get out of the way. Now Michaels, kip up there, going after him, reverse atomic drop, slams him down on the ground. Shawn Michaels starting to feel it here. Shawn Michaels sets him up, and down goes Mills. Once again, rolling out of the ring, very smart by the rookie, knowing that he's close enough to the ropes that he can just roll right out and get away from Shawn Michaels, get a little bit of a breather, and that could be what he needs right now. Backstabber. Backstabber by Mills puts Michaels down on the ground, off the ropes, delivers a running knee right to the face of Shawn Michaels. Looked like it hit him flush on the chin. And now, oh, a super kick! A super kick of Mills' own! Mills using a super kick against the man who pretty much revolutionized the super kick. But this time, Mills had Michaels a little bit too close to the ropes and was unable to capitalize on it. Now, Mills, oh! And looked like a neckbreaker there on Shawn Michaels, who is now in big, big trouble. Corey Mills flipping over and takes Shawn Michaels down. Shawn Michaels is down and he is not moving, ladies and gentlemen. Corey Mills moves him to the center of the ring, goes for the cover, and he will get the three count. Corey Mills, the newcomer here in the NWL, making his debut on the debut episode of Season 2, picks up a huge victory against Shawn Michaels. That is big. That is big for this young rookie. It is also very detrimental to Shawn Michaels, who is probably looking to try and get back on track tonight and pick up a victory, but he is unable to, as the rookie puts in a great effort and picks up his first victory here in the NWL. So a great match is going to start us off here tonight as a great night of action we have for you. Our main event, ladies and gentlemen, I am just been informed by our general manager, Mick Foley. It is a huge one, and it is going to be wild. Carnage, the Intercontinental Champion, is teaming up with Vincent Andolini. These two have teamed together multiple times before, and they are taking on the team of Sting and Chaz Parker. That is a volatile team, ladies and gentlemen. The current NWL Champion versus the former NWL Champion. How are these two guys going to be able to coexist in the ring? I have no idea, but I'm going to have a hell of a lot of fun watching this match to find out. I hope you guys do too. That is our main event. Let's go ahead and get our next match underway. And it's none other than CM Punk versus Wade Barrett, who had a little bit of a disagreement at WrestleMania as Punk pinned Barrett last in a battle royal match to determine the new number one contender for Carnage's Intercontinental title. These two are going to square off right now for you guys. So here we go, CM Punk versus Wade Barrett, one-on-one action here, as it is kind of a little bit of a rematch, I guess you could say, from WrestleMania. Both these guys were in that Battle Royal match to determine the number one contender to the Intercontinental Championship. It came down to these two as two of the final three. It also included Leroy Brown. Wade Barrett picks up the pin on Leroy Brown to remove him from the match, and just as he's getting back up after the pin, Punk lifts him on his shoulder and hits to go to sleep and gets the victory. It was a quick succession there for Wade Barrett. He probably didn't even know what was happening, and so now he is looking for a little bit of retribution against CM Punk, looking to try and prove to him that he should be facing off against Carnage for the title, not CM Punk. This will be a very competitive, very hard-hitting match between these two. I have a feeling Barrett is more of the brawler type, CM Punk more of the technical type. Clashing styles, nothing but good things can come from that, ladies and gentlemen. So we're in for one hell of a match. It's Barrett lifting Punk up and slamming him down. Punk catches him with a kick, though, and takes him down with a leg drag. Barrett now trying to get a little bit of momentum going with a couple little punches. Stay has Punk, and now slamming Punk's head right into the turnbuckle. Wade Barrett slamming Punk's head straight into that turnbuckle. And yes, those things are padded, and it is a good thing they are, because if they weren't, CM Punk would have some major damage onto his head right now. He could have a busted lip or something. Maybe a broken nose even as it is. Barrett grabbing Punk, but Punk's able to reverse it and get out. Punk lifts Barrett up and slams him down. Ooh, winds of change. The winds of change from Wade Barrett looking for the cover on CM Punk. Only gets a one count though. It's a little bit too early in this match, Barrett, to be able to pick up the victory that way. You gotta try and wear CM Punk down a little bit more than that if you wanna get a pinfall victory off the winds of change like that. And now, short left-handed jabs to Punk's face. Already gotten driven into the turnbuckle, now getting a fist driven into it. Not turning into a very good night for CM Punk. Barrett tries to pick CM Punk up, but instead Punk reverses it. And then gets an elbow to the head. Not a good night for CM Punk's head right now. Is now gets Barrett in a submission, but Barrett able to get the rope break. Legs grabbing onto the ropes. First match back in the season and already got a lot of rope breaks going on. You guys gotta get your guys away from the ropes. Can't let them get this close and or anything here. Is Barrett now going for a submission bow and arrow here. Punk able to reverse it. He's a submission expert, Barry. He knows every submission inside and out. You gotta wear him down a lot more if you expect to get him to tap with that. Barrett now gets Punk up and slams him down. Throws him into the corner. Now lifting Punk up onto the top turnbuckle. This could be very bad for both as now Punk able to reverse it, kick to the head, and now goes flying, flips over Barrett and takes him down with an amazing neckbreaker. Punk going high red off the ropes, the springboard there, but is no good. Barrett gets out of the way and then takes CM Punk down, gets on top of him now and laying the fists of fury in right to the head of CM Punk. As we said earlier, he's already taking a lot of punishment to the head. It's just going to get him more and more disoriented in this match. He's not going to really be able to string moves together or really be able to even focus, or could be seeing doubles of Wade Barrett at this point in time. Punk now takes Barrett and throws him into the corner turnbuckle there. Shoulder first. But Barrett lifting Punk up. Barrett with the wasteland. Wasteland by Wade Barrett. Goes for the pin on CM Punk. Punk kicks out just a 2.5. I have no idea how CM Punk was able to kick out of that one, but he did by some miracle. Now going for an abdominal stretch that Wade Barrett's able to reverse. Barrett right now in complete control of this match, but CM Punk lifting Barrett up out of nowhere. Hits the go to sleep. Go to sleep by CM Punk to Wade Barrett, but he doesn't go for the pin. Punk, why do you not go for the pin? That could have been just like at WrestleMania. Go to sleep, the pin. He could have had it. Instead, now Wade Barrett's regrouping on the outside. He's holding his head now. That go to sleep is not a move that you want to be feeling on a regular basis here. Barrett hangs up CM Punk on the top rope there as he's getting back into the ring and now picks him up and slams him down. Nice German suplex there. Wade Barrett going right back at CM Punk. Now trying for a submission, but he's way too close to the ropes. That is not going to work. Barrett, you got to learn. Can't have him be that close to the ropes. He did that to you and you were able to get away. Now Punk. Pump handle slam there. Puts Barrett down the ground. Wade Barrett throws Punk into the ropes. Picks him up. Atomic drop. Wade Barrett once again going for another submission. Has another submission on CM Punk, who is able to crawl to the ropes and get the break. Back and forth match here as Wade Barrett levels CM Punk with one hell of a punch. And now another submission, but Punk once again close enough to the ropes. These guys, man, trying to get the submission victories, but you gotta get them away from the ropes. Get them to the center of the ring. If you want a submission victory, they can't be by the ropes. They just can't. Come on, guys. It's wrestling 101. I don't even wrestle and I know these things, man. Take it from an innocent bystanding commentator here on what you have to do. Punk now drags Barrett to the center and he's going... Oh, I thought I was going for a submission there. I was about to say Punk finally learned. Going for a submission in the center of the ring for once. Instead, CM Punk could be setting him up. CM Punk setting him up for the Anaconda Vice. The Anaconda Vice by CM Punk. The Anaconda Vice is locked in and Wade Barrett has no choice but to tap out. Wade Barrett was trapped in the Anaconda Vice by CM Punk and he has no other choice but to tap out. CM Punk, an impressive victory there, coming from behind. As he was down and out for most of that beginning part of the match, stayed with it, did not give up, and finally had his opportunity and took it with the Anaconda Vice. So from one match with WrestleMania opponents to another one, we have a WrestleMania rematch here, ladies and gentlemen, as Agent Smith is going one-on-one against Ronald McDonald. It is a no disqualifications match between these two. Their feud is not over yet. They have one more try to settle their differences. Agent Smith looking to put Ronald McDonald down once and for all, and he can use anything at his disposal to do that. These two are going to unleash hell against each other, all in our new arena. We might not have this place for very much longer after these guys get through. Let's go ahead and get the match started to see the carnage that they cause. Here we go, Agent Smith, Ronald McDonald, one-on-one, and McDonald comes running at Smith, who takes him down instantly. These two have a lot of pent-up anger and aggression towards each other, and what better place to vent that anger and aggression than right here in an NWL ring, ladies and gentlemen. That's what this is meant for. Smith has gotten the upper hand on McDonald a couple times. McDonald's gotten the upper hand on Smith a couple times. This is the rubber match between the two. Smith won at Night of Champions, McDonald at WrestleMania. Now, this is the final match to see once and for all who is the better superstar. In this match, anything goes. There are no rules. There are no disqualifications. You can do anything you want to your opponent. Beat the living hell out of each other. That's what I'm saying. Do anything. Any way to pick up the victory. It's all game. It is all game. One of the most brutal matches you could possibly be a part of. And I don't really see a better rivalry than this one between Agent Smith and Ronald McDonald. Is Smith delivering a huge boot to McDonald. Levels him right there and then levels him again. McDonald now looking to try and get something going, but Smith able to reverse it. McDonald kicks away. Now gets him in a submission hold, but Agent Smith easily able to break out of that one. Gonna have to really weaken Smith up a lot more than that, McDonald, if you want to try and get him to submit as he throws him over the top rope there. Action is spilt out to the outside. Only good things can come from this in this type of match. And there it is. Ronald McDonald goes flying over the steel steps, which now gets picked up by Agent Smith and driven right into the face of Ronald McDonald. Agent Smith now using those steel steps once again, driving it into the face of Ronald McDonald, throwing into the ring now. The ref is now up to 6 in this match. You can be counted out, I guess. I did not know you could be counted out in a no disqualification match, but I guess so. McDonald, though, makes it back into the ring as it looks like he's back in for more punishment. Agent Smith has taken control of this match now. Those shots by the steel steps there, I think really, really has affected Ronald McDonald. I mean, why wouldn't they? I want to see anyone get hit with steel steps and really be 100% after that. McDonald, though, spinning back fist to the face of Agent Smith. Good job. Could be trying to get back into this thing as he picks him up and slams him right back down with a Samoan drop there. Spinning dropkick, patented move of Ron McDonald. We've seen him use that so many times before. Agent Smith was a little woozy there, but McDonald didn't capitalize. He really should have. You cannot give Agent Smith any time to recover. McDonald tripping over those steel steps in the ring right now. And if you let Agent Smith get a little bit of an opening, he's going to make you pay. The Matrix man does not care. He has no remorse, no caring whatsoever. He is all about destruction. And he has been doing that ever since he made his debut here in the NWL. No doubt about that. Now going under the ring, Agent Smith pulls out a chair. Agent Smith with a chair right to the face of Ronald McDonald. He didn't even see that coming until it was too late. Agent Smith is not stopping there. Throws the chair to McDonald and now a punch right through the chair. Ronald McDonald is woozy. Ronald McDonald is not standing very good right now. Gets back into the ring, though. Ref is at 6. Agent Smith, you need to get back in there. Gets back in at 7. Goes right back at McDonald now. Ooh. Takes him down, sweeps his leg out, and McDonald goes face first into the mat. Now picks him up by his one leg and slams his knee down into the mat. Ronald McDonald, though, comes running back with a little bit of a vengeance there. Clothesline levels Agent Smith, but does not keep him leveled for long. McDonald, you gotta keep on this man. You can't just give him time to rest up or get going again. You have to stay on him. McDonald now goes for a huge move, picks him up and takes him out. Ronald McDonald, he's feeling it right now. He's feeling it. Could have been looking for a possible McSlam there. Instead, Agent Smith picks him up. Ooh, and slams him down himself. McDonald, though, gets right back up into the fray, though, and then gets leveled. A huge, huge punch by Agent Smith levels Ronald McDonald. The steel steps are back in the hands of Agent Smith, and they go back into the face of Ronald McDonald. He's in big trouble right now. He's had a couple flashes of greatness in this match, but he has not been able to capitalize. He's not been able to string those all together. He's not been able to keep Agent Smith on the defense here. Instead, Smith has been able to gain the offense every single time, and now Smith looking to put McDonald away, picking him up, going for the red pill. The red pill by Agent Smith. And that is for sure going to be the end of Ronald McDonald. Agent Smith gets the rubber match between the two of them. A no disqualification match that he controlled from almost the very beginning. Ever since using those steel stairs on the outside of the ring on Ronald McDonald, he never looked back after that. McDonald had a couple good moments, but not enough as he falls to the Matrix Man. And so an amazing night of action here in the NWL now comes to a head. It is our main event, ladies and gentlemen. The Intercontinental Champion Carnage and Vincent Andolini team up against the Valdo team, no doubt, of the NWL Champion Sting and former champion Chaz Parker. Parker and Sting fought tooth and nail for that NWL Championship at WrestleMania. Chaz congratulated him earlier in the night, but says that he is coming to win that title back. He promises it. How are these two going to be able to coexist and overcome the team of Carnage and Andolini? They might not be able to, ladies and gentlemen, and it's going to be fun to watch them either win or explode trying. Let's go ahead and get the match started right now.
Bye.
event time here, ladies and gentlemen, in the NWL. It is Carnage and Andolini versus Sting and Chaz Parker. As you can see, Carnage is stirring things off with Chaz Parker in this match. It is going to be an amazing match between these guys, ladies and gentlemen. It's funny, actually, Carnage and Andolini, you would think no one would be able to team with Carnage. I mean, really, he doesn't team up against anyone that often. Usually, he just goes it solo. But surprisingly, him and Vincent Andolini, this is like the second or third time these guys have teamed up together, and they've actually made a pretty good pair, the two of them. They've actually been able to win, I think, one if not all of their matches that they have teamed together in. So they are a very, very good team, and they are facing off against a team that I don't know if they can coexist. I don't see how they possibly could. As right now, the two teams have kind of devolved into chaos right now. Andolini going after Sting, and Carnage, who is not the legal man, going after Chaz Parker on the outside. Now Vincent Andolini going after Parker on the outside. So right now, no order except chaos right now in this match. Ref, you gotta get this thing under control. He's up to four. You can't just be counting. You gotta get these guys back under control, back in the ring. Chaz Parker goes flying over the steel steps to six. Vincent Andolini gets in the ring, so this Chaz. All right, some order has been restored. We can have the match again. Carnage tags it back in, and he'll go back after Chaz Parker. But like I was saying, Chaz Parker and Sting, I don't know how they can coexist. As Sting comes in, Carnage going right after him. Carnage goes right after him, and a power slam by Sting puts Carnage down to the ground. Oh, this is going to be good now, ladies and gentlemen. Carnage running right back after Sting. These two have quite a bit of bad blood between them, let's just say. It was none other than Sting who gave Carnage his very first loss here in the NWL. Carnage has only lost one match, okay? He's come in, dominated everyone, beat Spider-Man to become the Intercontinental Champion, beat everyone that's been put in front of him for that title. And then, in the weeks leading up to WrestleMania, Sting was able to pick up an amazing victory over Carnage. I never thought that I would see Carnage get defeated, and in an incredible match like that, I mean, it was amazing. But ever since then, Carnage has been trying to just destroy Sting. He's been beating him up, he's been jumping on him every opportunity. Finally, our general manager, Mick Foley, had to intervene to make sure WrestleMania didn't devolve into chaos and that these two wouldn't interfere in each other's match. But now that they're in a match against each other like they are right now, right here, they can do whatever the hell they want to each other. And Carnage is taking advantage of that as he hits a beautiful whisper in the wind there. He's been completely dominating Sting right now. No offense by the NWL Champion against the Intercontinental Champion. And now the Stinger is in even more trouble as Carnage hits a pedigree. Carnage with a pedigree to Sting, going for the cover. And Chaz gets in there to break it up. It is a good thing because I don't think Sting was going to be able to kick out. I guess that puts to rest the ability of these two being able to team with each other, although Chaz probably wants to win this match as much as Sting does. So he could just be partly looking out for himself as Carnage. Beautiful enziguri kick right to the head of Sting in the corner there. And now just teeing off and kicking him right in the gut, right in the kidney region. That is going to knock the wind and just the stamina right out of Sting. I've been kicked in the kidneys before, guys, and it does not feel good. Every one of those shots is making me cringe right now. You just basically have this like pain and then can't breathe. It's horrible. It is horrible as Carnage takes Sting out with a spiked DDT. Sting was running to the corner to try and tag Chaz in, I believe. and Carnage once again stopping him, once again preventing the tag from being made, and once again another whisper in the wind. Sting is in a world of trouble right now. He's gotta find a way to tag Chaz into this match if he wants any chance at all of winning, any chance at all of just surviving. He has to tag Chaz in, because Carnage is going to rip him apart in this match. Springboard off the ropes, Carnage flipping and turning in midair. Sting, Sting is just out of it, man. He has nothing left. He comes running in, and Carnage had him set up for that. Sting is in a world of trouble. Carnage is taking his time to destroy Sting, too. He isn't even going for the pin anymore. I think he's just taking pleasure in destroying the NWL champion right now. This is sickening, guys. This is sickening. Sting really needs to try and find a way to tag Chaz in. He's so close to his side, and he does! Here comes Chaz Parker! Here comes the former NWL champion coming in, takes out Carnage, goes after Andolini, takes him out. He's in this match. He is ready to get his hands on Carnage, has him up, and hits the F5! F5 from Chaz Parker to Carnage, dragging him to the center of the ring, goes for the pin. 1, 2... Carnage kicks out. Carnage kicks out of the F5 by Chaz Parker. But he is still in there. He is still the fresher man. He is still going to try and take it to Carnage if he can. Has him in the corner, but Carnage tagging in Vincent Angelini. His job is done. Sting is out of the ring. It is now time for the Godfather to make his presence known against Chaz Parker. These two do not have the best working relationship. Chaz Parker and Vincent Angelini have fought for the title. There was a triple threat match that also included Cowboy Keith a while back. And then Chaz Parker actually won his championship against Angelini. He was able to beat Angelini for the title at Night of Champions. That is why Angelini was not in the main event at WrestleMania. He tried to reclaim it, but he was unable to do it. Chaz now getting thrown into the corner. Angelini comes running in, delivers a forearm right there in the corner. Chaz gets back up, still ready to fight, but Angelini picks him up, spinning him around. It's just business, Chaz. It is just business. 2, and Chaz kicks out. Angelini trying to finish up Chaz Parker with the just business tombstone. But he's unable to as Chaz kicks out of it. Sting on the apron there, trying to possibly cause a little bit of distraction. Swinging right now, but he's unable to hit Angelini. I think that he's a little bit out of it still. He had no coordination there trying to take Angelini out. Carnage destroyed Sting. He completely and utterly dominated him when he was in the ring. And now, Vincent Angelini has started to completely and utterly dominate Chaz Parker. He's tagged in Carnage now. Drop Toho into an elbow drop by Carnage. Oh, and then one of those kicks right to the kidneys. This time of Chaz Parker is off the springboard ropes. Chaz in trouble. Back-to-back ones there. Carnage and Angelini have just dominated this match. Sting and Chaz have not been able to get on the same page together now. Swanton Bomb! A Swanton Bomb by Carnage. Here's the pin. 2. Oh, and Chaz is able to kick out. It's not over yet. Chaz still showing some life, still showing some fight in him. But Carnage could be signaling the end here. Kick to the gut, setting him up for the pedigree. Pedigree! Carnage hits the pedigree on Chaz Parker, and Vincent Angelini comes in, kicks Sting off the apron, and Carnage picks up the victory. Carnage and Angelini systematically took apart the NWL Champion and Chaz Parker. Parker and Sting were never on the same page, not during the entire match. They could not make effective tags, could not do anything together, and Carnage and Andolini took advantage and pick up a huge victory here tonight. Oh, and now it looks like Carnage is not done. He's over the body of Sting, but wait, here comes CM Punk! It's CM Punk! CM Punk, the number one contender to Carnage's Intercontinental Championship, comes to the aid of Sting and takes out Carnage. He is making a statement of his own to Carnage right there, saying that I am coming for your championship sooner or later, Carnage. You better watch your back and not worry too much about Sting, because I am the one that's coming for you. That will be all the time that we have for you tonight, ladies and gentlemen. And it was an amazing night of action to start off the new season of the NWL. Great matches, a debuting superstar, a new arena, and rivalries that are renewed and continuing, ladies and gentlemen. All in all, a great night of action. I can't wait till next week's episode, where I'm sure there will be more twists and turns, as there always is here in the NWL. If you enjoyed tonight's episode, please go ahead and leave a like, as well as any comments you may have down below. Otherwise, I'm KJ, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!